Hello everyone, I'm Brett, and today is an exciting day because for the last couple weeks we've been working so hard to learn all we can about radicals. We've learned about square roots and cubed roots and higher indexed roots. We've learned how to add and subtract radicals, how to simplify radicals, how to rationalize denominators, and today we get to take it one step further by introducing algebra into our radicals. Now today I'm going to show you two separate techniques for simplifying radicals with variables. You could choose either technique. I'm going to show both of them to you so that way you can kind of decide for yourself which you like better. The first technique is going to have to do with radical notation, and the second technique is going to have to do with fractional notation. In this first problem, we want to simplify the square root of x cubed y z to the fourth. So when I'm working with square roots, I'm always looking for groups of two, because I know that, for instance, the square root of x squared is simply x, or the square root of 2 squared is simply 2. I think that's the easiest way to approach these. So as you can tell in this problem, we have 3 x's. So I can make one group of 2, and then I'll have a third x by itself. And I have 4 z's, so I can make 2 groups of 2 there. So what I'm going to do in this first step is I'm just going to split these out into little groups of 2. This is just a little baby step to get us started, and if you're new to this, I think it's a really good step to start with. So I went ahead and split these into separate radicals as well, and I think that's a really handy thing to do because it helps us just really clearly see when things break free of the radical. Sometimes people just kind of do it all underneath the radical, and that's okay if you understand it, but while you're learning, sometimes that's a little confusing. So I always split them apart. And then just like I said, I made groups of 2 out of the things I had at least 2 of. So I split x cubed into an x squared and x, and I split the z to the fourth into a z squared and z squared. Now I'm just gonna go ahead and just cancel out anything that reduces. So the square root and the squares reduce. And so now all I have left under the square roots is the x and y. So I want to put those back together into one root. And then I want to take everything that is no longer in a root and write it in front. So that technique worked really well with this problem. I think that's probably the easiest way to do it, but I'm going to show you how to use fractional exponents as well, because in some scenarios that might end up being easier, or you might just prefer it more. So I'm going to do the same problem with the alternate method. In this method, we're going to get rid of the square root immediately and replace it with a power of 1/2. Then I'm going to use those exponent rules because I have these variables all being raised to the 1/2 power, so I'm going to multiply. And remember that y, there's no number written on this, so we can write in a 1 to just kind of help us. So I'm going to multiply 3 with 1/2, 1 with 1/2, and 4 with 1/2. All right, now I'm just going to simplify. So the z to the 4/2, well, 4 divided by 2 is 2, so I'm just going to replace that with a 2. The 1/2 I'm going to leave as is on this one, and then the 3/2 I'm going to rewrite as a mixed number instead of an improper fraction. So this becomes x to the 1/2. And the reason why it's useful to do that is 1/2 is the same as 1 plus 1/2. And remember, when I'm multiplying two values together that have the same base, I can add their exponents. So here I'm just going to do the reverse of that. Instead of combining things to make one value, I'm going to separate them back into two separate ones. And you'll see how that works out really nicely. Like I said, I just split this into two separate terms. And then I have that y to the half and z squared, like I said above. So as you can tell, we only have two letters left that have exponents that are fractions. They both have a fraction of 1/2, so I can combine those back into that square root. And then I have these variables that I can write out in front. Again, I don't need to write the 1 down here since that's implied, so I just have x times z squared in front. That gives us the same answer as we had up here. So as you can see, both methods work really well for simplifying that radical. this next problem, we're dealing with a cube root, which looks more difficult, but it's actually going to work out very similarly to how we did the first problem. But instead of looking for these groups of twos, I'm going to be looking for groups of threes since I have a cube root. So my first step is to split up the radicals with each thing that's being multiplied, and I'm going to split out a to the fifth into as many groups of threes as I can, and b to the ninth into as many groups of threes as it can as well. Because I broke these up into groups of threes, I now can see where the canceling needs to happen. So anything that has a cube root and a power of three on it are inverses of each other and cancel. That's just going to leave me the a and b's behind. Also, I know that the cube root of 8 is 2, because 8 is equal to 2 cubed. So I'm also going to go ahead and reduce this whole thing down to 2. Now I'm free to do some cross-canceling. I see that I have 2 b's in the numerator being multiplied together and 2 b's in the denominator being multiplied together. So those are going to divide to 1, so I can go ahead and cross-cancel out those and check for anything else that can be reduced. I don't see anything else, so now I'm just going to rewrite this in a nice form. I'm going to move this b out in front of the radical and clean this up a little bit. In this method, instead of writing a cube root, I'm going to start by trading out the cube root for a power of 1/3, and I'm going to make sure to wrap parentheses around anything that was inside that cube root. Now I can go ahead and apply the 1/3 power onto each value inside of the parentheses. At this point, I can go ahead and rewrite the 5/3 as a mixed number, so that's going to be 1 2/3. That means that I can write a to the first power times a to the 2/3 power. Of course, we're free to cancel out the b squared in the denominator with two of the b's from the numerator. Now I'm just going to reintroduce the cube roots back into the problem. So anything that has a fractional exponent with a denominator of 3 is going to get a cube root symbol. Notice how when I reintroduced the cube root symbol on the a, I kept the power of 2 on the a, so I still have a squared here. Now the last step is to take the cube root of 8, which we know is 2, and rewrite this in a nice pretty form. There you go, that is the same as we got up here when we used the radical notation method. If you found this lesson useful, I would really, really appreciate it if you give it a big thumbs up. And as always, I invite you to join the Math Hacks community. All you have to do is hit the subscribe button below, and then you're one of us. Until next time, I'm Brett, and thank you for joining me.